Hello everyone, you're watching Physio Classroom channel, and in this second video of Brunstrom therapy series, we are going to learn about the important components of upper limb flexion and extension synergies as seen in stroke or hemiplegia patients. Now, synergy simply means to work together. And when we talk about movement synergy, then this can be defined as the synchronized activation of different muscles to produce purposeful movement with maximum precision and with minimal wastage of energy. Now, movement synergy can also be referred to as a movement pattern, and a normal human brain has the ability to produce limitless or innumerable movement patterns in his daily life. Now, let's understand movement synergies with few examples. Now, if I am doing the combing activity, then this movement synergy or movement pattern is brought about by co-activation of the shoulder muscles, elbow muscles, and the muscles of forearm, wrist, and hand in a particular synchronized manner. So this particular action is brought about by the synergistic activation of the shoulder flexors, abductors, and external rotators, along with the elbow flexors and supinators, the wrist radial deviators and extensors, and finger flexors. So these all muscles form one synergy pattern. Now, a normal human brain has this ability to use different movement synergy patterns to carry out different types of work. So the movement synergies that will be required to carry out work like brushing, eating, drinking, writing, painting, plumbing, gardening, etc., all will use different combinations of muscle activation, and hence the normal human brain has this ability to use limitless combinations of movement synergies, and dancing is one such characteristic example in which we can use variety of movement synergies to assume different body postures. Now, before we move on with the description of upper limb synergies in hemiplegic patients, let's discuss one last interesting thing about the normal movement synergy, and that is that some stereotyping does occur in normal movement patterns. So let's take up this example of writing to understand this. So whenever we have to write something, we need to have this wrist extension and radial deviation to perform this activity. So although I can modify the position of my shoulder into flexion, extension, adduction, abduction, and perform that activity, I can even modify the position of my elbow in flexion and extension, but still I need to have this co-activation of extension and radial deviation along with flexion of the fingers to perform the activity, which indicates that there is some stereotyping that exists in normal movement patterns. Now, in contrast to normal synergy movement patterns, the hemiplegic patients demonstrate basic limb synergies that are characteristically stereotyped and do not permit different combinations of muscle activation. So basic limb synergies in stroke patients can be defined as mass movement patterns which are stereotypic in response to a stimulus or a voluntary effort. So this simply means that either reflexively or voluntarily, the patient will only be able to characteristically stimulate the same combination of muscle movements, and so the variety or the ability to produce variety of movements will be characteristically lost in such patients. So the basic upper limb synergies that we see in a hemiplegic patient are limited to gross flexor movement, which we call as the flexor synergy, gross extensor movements, which we call as the upper limb extensor synergy, and the synergy that is produced from the combination of the strong components of upper limb flexion and extension synergy is referred to as the mixed synergy. So let's discuss them one by one. Now, as soon as the flaccidity starts getting replaced by the onset of spasticity, one can expect to see these basic limb synergies to appear in stroke patients. Now, the important components of the upper limb flexor synergy in hemiplegic patients are shoulder retraction, elevation, along with shoulder external rotation and abduction, elbow flexion and forearm supination, along with wrist and finger flexion. So the flexion synergy would look something like this. Now the important points regarding the upper limb flexor synergy to be noted are that we will often find variability in the range of motion of the flexor synergy. So a patient who has just come out of the flaccid phase will only be able to initiate the flexor synergy movement, whereas the patient in the advanced stage of spasticity might show the complete range of the flexor synergy. Another important thing to be noted is that elbow flexion is the strongest component of the upper limb flexor synergy. Another important thing to be noted is that upper limb flexor synergy movement is typically initiated by either the elbow flexion movement or the shoulder elevation movement. That means the patient initiates the flexor synergy by recruiting the elbow flexors and shoulder elevators. Rest of the muscles of the synergy follow the activation of these muscles. It is also important to note that some stroke or hemiplegic patients might display shoulder hyperextension during the performance of the upper limb flexor synergy. So that means that rather than going into more of abduction and external rotation, these patients might go into more extension during the performance of the upper limb flexor movement. So now let's discuss the upper limb extensor synergy in a hemiplegic patient. The extensor synergy components are shoulder protraction along with shoulder internal rotation and adduction so that the arm crosses to the front of the body. Now this is accompanied with elbow extension and forearm pronation. The wrist is sometimes seen to be extended along with finger flexion. Now it is important to note that wrist extension with finger flexion is not universal to the extensor synergy. The important components being the protraction along with shoulder internal rotation, adduction, elbow extension and forearm pronation. Characteristically, finger extension is never seen in the extensor synergy of upper limb. Now the strongest components of the upper limb extensor synergy are shoulder adduction and internal rotation. And the next strongest component in the extensor synergy is forearm pronation. So now if we compare the upper limb flexor and extensor synergies based on strong and weak components, we can conclude this that the shoulder elevation and retraction of the flexor synergy is stronger than the shoulder protraction of the extensor synergy. Another thing that we can conclude is that the shoulder adduction and internal rotation of the extensor synergy is stronger as compared to the shoulder abduction and external rotation movement of the flexor synergy. Similarly, the elbow flexion movement of the flexor synergy is stronger as compared to the elbow extension movement of the extensor synergy pattern. And finally, the forearm pronation of the extensor synergy is much stronger as compared to the forearm supination of the flexor synergy pattern. Now, why this information is important is because from this we can have an idea and explanation about why few movements are easily producible and few movements are difficult to be produced by the stroke patient. A stroke patient finds it difficult to extend the elbow, to abduct the shoulder, to supinate. This is so because these are the weaker components of flexor and extensor synergy patterns. So now the movement synergy that we get after combining the stronger patterns of both the upper limb flexor and extensor synergy is referred to as the mixed synergy. So the important components of the mixed synergy are shoulder elevation and retraction along with shoulder adduction and internal rotation, elbow flexion and forearm pronation. And this is a typical hemiplegic posture for the upper limb. And so now we can easily give explanation to why a hemiplegic assumes this typical posture. This is because of the combined action of the stronger components of the upper limb flexor and extensor synergy patterns. Now it is important to note that hemiplegic patients cannot perform isolated movements when they are bound by these movement synergies. So for example, a hemiplegic patient wants to bend the elbow, then he won't be able to do it without producing scapular retraction and elevation along with shoulder abduction movement. So every time, the effort to initiate the elbow flexion will be accompanied with activation of the rest of the muscles of that synergy. So this was all about the basic upper limb synergy patterns that are seen in hemiplegic patients. In our third video of Brunstrom therapy series, we will be talking about the lower limb synergy patterns. So see you all in our next video. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing, and stay connected.